الصبح بدا من طلعته والليل دجى من وفرته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته الله 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 الله
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد all praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala peace and salutations be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam respected viewers of ITV assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh welcome to another edition of the program Riyad Us Saliheen Gardens of the Righteous and we welcome day number 3 of the blessed month of Ramadan 1440 the third of Ramadan 48 hours of the blessed month of Ramadan have already passed by us perhaps we still adjusting our schedules and getting used to the month of Ramadan at the same time we enjoying the wonderful fasting for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that feeling and joy and ecstasy that is felt the moment the adhan is called out when we are breaking our fast subhanallah those are indeed precious and priceless moments that we have the good fortune of experiencing but 2 days of the month of Ramadan have already passed by us I hope that we are making the best of every moment of this blessed month of Ramadan it does take time to get into the system and to arrange our schedules with waking up earlier than usual and the change of pattern with regards to our eating habits but then again let's not forget that where we are in here in South Africa it's still the winter season mashallah so the fast is relatively shorter compared to other parts of the year or in other seasons as well so we have a bit of a short fast and sometimes it becomes a bit more hectic with regards to the day being shorter than usual but still we need to also do the best that we can and enjoy it over the fast that we are keeping for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and at the same time we're looking forward to the reward that is promised to those people that are fasting for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala We're currently discussing Babu Sabr, the chapter of patience. That is our journey for this blessed month of Ramadan as compared to last Ramadan when we had started this compilation, Riyad Us Saliheen, and we discussed at great length the chapter of the importance of intention. Every deed that is done must be done for the correct reason and accordingly you get your reward when it is done solely and only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our journey for this blessed month of Ramadan, since it's Shahru Sabr, the month of patience our journey is through the chapter of patience learning from the various verses of the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the great rewards for this aspect of patience when it is found in the life of any person and also we will be going through the narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaking about this aspect of patience and I think it's very important that we remind ourselves of this because as much as the month of Ramadan has been highlighted by the blessed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been the month of patience and the fasting has come to teach us this quality of patience unfortunately sometimes there's a bit of impatience that is also displayed and comes to the fore in the month of Ramadan that is due to our own weakness but when we look at these at the aspect of the Quran speaking of patience and the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then it gives us that courage and it gives us that inspiration inshallah to be more patient for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the verse that we discussed in the last program innama yuwaffas sabiruna ajrahum bighairi hisab Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that he will recompensate and he will give reward to those people that are patient without any measure and the other interpretation is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give people Jannah those that are patient without any reckoning that is the reward that the patient people will receive they will get Jannah without going through the process of a reckoning and a account taken of their deeds in this world because they were patient Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through his kindness and mercy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them with jannah another verse of the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says walaman sabara wa ghafara inna dhalika lamin azmi al-umur Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that indeed those that exercise patience wa ghafara and they forgive others for the difficulties and hardships that others have meted out against them or for whatever reason you overlook the faults of somebody else so those that are patient and those that forgive inna dhalika lamin azmi al-umur Allah says that these are from the most courageous of matters because it takes a lot for you to be patient, and it takes a lot for you to overlook the wrong that has been done to you. It's not everyone's cup of tea. We think we're strong, we think we're courageous. Look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala highlights really being strong. It takes a lot of emotional strength. It takes a lot of maturity for a person to be patient over whatever difficulty has come upon them, and it takes a lot of courage indeed, and it takes a lot of emotional strength when we rise up to the challenge of forgiving and overlooking others for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the most important thing. We're not looking at anything else. That's the common mistake we make. We look at other aspects, we look at different avenues, but when you keep the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of you, when you're focused and you have your goal that I am, for example, forgiving this person only because Allah will be happy, and it is only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then that is a very courageous matter that takes a lot of strength, and that is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dearly loves. And then Allah says, Ista'inu bisabri wassala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that seek the assistance and the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by being patient, and seek the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by performing salah and hastening towards prayer. When we look at the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was such in his nature that the moment any difficulty or hardship would come upon him, immediately he would turn to salah. And that is plays a pivotal role in the life of every Muslim, the aspect of salah. And mashallah, the blessed month of Ramadan that has come upon us, we know that we a lot more punctual with our salah. That is wonderful, mashallah. But let's try and focus, inshallah, that throughout our lives we need to do our level best to be punctual with our salah. That is the ultimate avenue of seeking the help and assistance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is perhaps the strongest link that we have, or the fastest avenue that we have available to us to get the assistance and the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how sad would it be if a person finds themselves in such a situation that they are in desperate need of Allah's help? And who doesn't need help and assistance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Every one of us need it and are in desperate need of it in some way or the other. We need the help of Allah. We have so many challenges. We have so many problems. So we are in desperate need of help and assistance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then the very avenue that Allah has given for that help and assistance to come to us and to get it, we don't go to that. That's rather fortunate indeed if we find ourselves in that situation, because the moment we have a problem and the fastest way to get Allah's help, Allah has already given you the solution. Turn to Him in prayer. Be patient, you'll get the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you're impatient and there's a lack of prayer in your life, how is it that we're ever going to overcome our difficulties and problems? How is it that we're going to get the help and assistance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So that's some food for thought for us on this third day of the blessed month of Ramadan, that Allah says, you want His help, be patient and perform your salah, turn to Allah in prayer. You do those two things, the help of Allah is with you. And if the help of Allah is with you, what else do you desire? No problem will be too big to solve, no challenge will be too difficult to go through and for you to bear, because you have Allah's help. But if you don't have the help of Allah, you don't exercise the avenue of patience and prayer, then the smallest of challenges will become too difficult for us to bear. The slightest or the lightest of challenges will become too burdensome for us to carry. Yet Allah has given us the solution. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. That brings us to the end of today's discussion of Riyad Us Saliheen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الصبح بدا من طلعته والليل دجى من وفرته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته الله.